garage time.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to episode 2 of Garage Time. I want to thank you for watching these videos. This is a new channel for me, and I'm learning how to film and edit and work at the same time. So if it's going slow, I apologize. I'm trying to improve the content each week. And so for this week, we are going to continue on the back date of the front fenders on this 1974 911. Okay, so now I'm just in the process of tracing this turn signal housing onto some cardboard. Try to continue the contour here. This I have to guess a little bit. Give it a little gap. Just try to eyeball it the best we can. And trace. So that looks like a relatively smooth arc from front to back. And we also need to account for the gasket and also a flange. So I need to think about that, but this is just the outer portion of that. I also have the lens, so you account for the thickness of the lens and possibly a gasket. Okay, so now I've got my great shape. You know, this is the curve created by the turn signal and that front grille. I'm just doing arbitrary 2 inches to create the width of that panel. Normally I would investigate what the actual part is. I'm just going based on pictures, and I keep telling myself this is just a hot rod, so you know, close enough is good enough. So I'm just gonna guess at it and then connect the dots. I just marked it out, and I'm gonna use my tin snips to cut it out. Gloves are a good idea. I usually don't like to wear gloves, but sometimes on a big part like this, you gotta pull pretty hard. So, better safe. So my arms are burning, but you know, this is a pretty straight cut, pretty even. Edges are pretty smooth still. Probably go over it with a die grinder. But yeah, there's better ways to cut this with power tools and shears and nibblers and stuff. I just don't have any. So that's what it is. So here's a view of the bead roller, and you know, it looks like it's from World War II, probably because it is. It's pretty old. Pexto and Wilcox. I had to modify, I spent about an hour modifying these rollers, because for the bend these are designed to do, you're supposed to use this groove here. You know, I needed to use it as a tipping die, so I needed the flat portion, so I had to shim this out and make some changes to the die, which is a little difficult, but you know, hopefully it should work. I've done some trials on here, and it seems to be okay. So now it's time to run the actual part. I have scribed some lines on here. They're a little faint for the video, but they're very fine lines that are scratched into the die chem just using a caliper. Well, that's three passes on both the inner and outer radius, and it worked pretty well. You know, a little bit of hammer and dolly work to do to finish it up, but you can see the flanges, there's one up, one down, and I think it's gonna work well. Probably a little easier than, you know, doing the alternative, which is the pliers. You know, this is probably 20 inches on either side, and it's hard to do around the corner. So this is a pretty smooth bend. We'll clean the ink off of this and measure it up to the fender, see if we can keep going. So like I said, I'm just gonna do a tiny bit of hammer and dolly. I don't have a perfect size dolly for this curvature, but this was kind of close. So just try to even it out a little bit. So here is the final piece. So we have a relatively good fit, a little on, little extra on the end, and then it follows the curvature just like that. All right, so I'm back at it again. And today I'm trying to attach the bottom bracket that was just made to the fender. And doing that requires some alignment. I put several marks on here to make sure we have this lined up to the housing and then the housing lined up to the fender. When I formed this piece, I made it extra long. So I'm gonna be trimming this end off so it mates up with this flange that was made on the fender. So I think it's gonna fit, but we'll see how it goes. So we put those small eighth inch holes in. You know, they're temporary, easy to weld. If they're in the wrong place, they're easy to close up. They're only eighth inch. And then for those of you that are familiar with these, they're called clecos. You probably like them. They're just temporary screws. So they go in. They go in like so. They're actually temporary rivets. So there's a tang that protrudes out. As you let go of the pressure, the spring inside keeps it clamped together. All right, so the next bracket here is this one pictured in the center. And it's a little hard to tell from the pictures, but it looks like a straight bracket, kind of twisted a little bit to follow the contour of the parts. And then it has a few holes drilled in it and a tab welded on the other side so we can attach the grille. So I'm gonna make a cardboard template first and see if we can get that shape. So I'm just tracing the shape of the housing onto some cardboard so I can try it out. I'm gonna add about 5/16, 3/8 of an inch to fold the flange over. I added some pie cuts into the template so I can fold the flange over the curve. Now the portion that hangs over the back here gets a bend so that the housing has something to screw into. So here's the template I came up with. Is it 100% authentic? No. Will it hold the housing in? Probably so. There's the shape traced on the part. Gonna do the final cut now. Looks like a shark tooth or shark tail. Well, I got the bead roller back out, only because it's now set up to bend the flange. Rather than use my pliers, I think I'm going to get it started here with the bead roller. All right, so I did 3 or 4 passes on the bead roller. And it does tip the flange over. It's pretty nice, but it still distorts the part. This is turned into a little concave here, so it's gonna still need some pliers and some hammer work. So after a few minutes, I ended up with this. And this is just the start. I haven't spent a lot of time on this flange here on the end, which is difficult to form. But it's starting to take shape, and it's starting to fit in the fender. Okay, so here's a close-up of the flange we just bent over, and it's pretty even, pretty happy with it. And as you can see, as I was using my hammer, I just have it clamped onto my welding table, which the table ends up being sort of a dolly, which is really helpful. But the other pieces I used were just, you know, this is an old piece of steel from a axle of some kind, I don't know. But these are the kind of things I typically will grab if it has the right size, radius, I can use it. Okay, before I can weld this new bracket to the fender, I need to take care of this hole. This hole was drilled when I removed the spot weld from the factory piece that was below it. So this is going to get tacked in right here, right about where that hole is. So I should just go ahead and take care of all these little bites that have been taken out of the flange, only because that's how it was originally made. So I'm going to fill in these holes all up and down and make sure that we have something continuous for the housing to fit into. So we actually enlarged this hole slightly just so that I can put a piece of filler material in there. So I'll use some cardboard to trace that onto some sheet metal and weld it in. And there's the piece in place, so you can tell it's actually taped in position. So because it's such a small piece and clamps are difficult to use, I just use tape. The tape burns pretty quickly in the welding, so you got to clean it real quick after it's done. But that's just how I patch these small holes. So the hokey tape has been removed. The first tack is in place. So now I'm just going to weld it around. Okay, that was a hard to reach little area, but it is welded all the way around, including into the crevice. So I like to leave the patch a little extra material on there, so it doesn't undercut or erode away when I'm doing the welding. So that can easily be trimmed off later. Unfortunately, that is all the time we have this week for this episode. The next episode, I really hope to finish at least one side, one fender. We get the entire thing converted. So please leave comments below if you have any questions or have suggestions to improve this channel. And of course, please subscribe for future videos, and we'll see you back next week.